And welcome to Weekends with Alex Witt. We start with a dramatic escalation in those Wall Street protests here in New York City. 700 people have been arrested after one of the biggest days of demonstrations yet. Protesters shut down a lane of traffic on the Brooklyn Bridge Saturday, shouting slogans about corporate greed and a whole slew of social issues. NBC's Michelle Franzen is joining me now here in studio. Michelle, with a good morning to you. What is it that these protesters want?
Well, that's exactly a good question. It's a variety of platforms that they're coming together to try and explain and try and get attention for. And as you can see from those arrests yesterday, that they are trying to get that message out that they mean business. And certainly those arrests yesterday are also starting to give shape to their message.
2 weeks and counting. Several hundred faithful protesters continue to camp out at a park near Wall Street. Their numbers grow each day, fueled by the power of social media, a few scuffles with NYPD, and the common thread of discontent over high unemployment and distrust of government and corporations.
There's something unjust going on right now in this economy and this society.
John Avitable drove from Connecticut to speak out.
Because we can't pay for big, expensive lobbyists to work for what we want.
The sit-in has turned into a small community, complete with a food kitchen and media center. But by design, there is no one leader of this group and no organized set of demands.
We're each doing our own thing, but we're doing it together. We're coming together and we're saying things need to be changed. How are we going to do this?
In Los Angeles, protesters took to the streets to show solidarity.
I can't travel to D.C., I can't travel to New York, so I think it's great that we are doing this in cities across the United States.
Even in Portland, Maine, 100 people turned out. The movement, labor experts say, is also gaining the attention of high-profile activists like Michael Moore and union leaders, backing that could elevate the conversation to the political stage.
This is a liberal version of the Tea Party, especially with young people who are getting mobilized and expressing their grievances. I think this could potentially carry over into the 2012 elections and get people to the polls.
So far, the protesters say they are just getting started.
And those protesters are expected to be back out there today. There's a few, several dozen that have been camped out there overnight, and they're starting to take shifts, starting to get a little bit more organized. And as I mentioned, they're getting the backing of some of the unions that are starting to speak out now, including the Steelworkers Union. And the Steelworkers Union, and they're expected to have a big rally coming this week.
Okay, we're going to look for all of that and see what happens today. Michelle Franzen, many thanks. Well, the protest is today's Twitter question. Occupy Wall Street, worthy cause or waste of time? Tell me what you think. My handle is at Alex Witt. I'll be reading some of your tweets a little bit later on in the show.